All right, new at 4. A family is accusing Arlington police of failing to follow proper protocols. It's been almost a year now since Tori Thompson died outside of a motel.
Loved ones claim that they were never told about his death until months later when they received a box of his ashes. Our Matthew Torres is in Arlington with more on what happened and a message for families.
He was overlooked.
Angela Thompson says she still questions why it took more than 4 months before she found out her son died.
He had his birth certificate on him. He had a letter from me that said.
She claims the backpack police returned to her contained enough information, including an ID, to help them track the next of kin.
Love, mommy.
This week marks 1 year since family says 33-year-old Tori Thompson died of a fentanyl overdose. An Arlington police incident report says he died in the parking lot of this Econo Lodge where he was trying to charge his phone. It's here where loved ones, including his two daughters, hold a small celebration of life. His mother says he was unhoused.
Because of his situation, this is where he found himself.
They didn't think anything was wrong until his birthday in November when they still couldn't get a hold of him. A loved one says another unhoused person in the community was the one who first told them Tori died as they were searching for him. They tried to file a missing persons report, but eventually learned that not only was he dead, but his body was already cremated. Here's the court order 2 months prior that granted cremation, which is allowed by law, citing there's been an exhaustive search and 10 days passed, but the body was still unclaimed.
I lived in the very home that Tori was raised in for over 20 years. I currently live in my current home for over 24 years. So if creditors can find us, if family members can find us, why can't the police find us?
The NAACP Arlington branch says it took the family filing a formal complaint before they received the incident report. They're demanding police to change the policy to have a liaison, additional training, and putting unclaimed death information into a national database.
We're calling for truth for Tori. And Tori mattered.
A police spokesperson tells WSA9 they met with the family earlier this year, and as a result, there's been further training to all detectives on procedures for unclaimed bodies, saying, quote, additional procedures were also established requiring the homicide robbery unit supervisor to review the case and ensure all steps have been taken before the process of unclaimed bodies can begin. Now, the family also helped start a new organization called Strength Together Network to help people going through a drug misuse by connecting them to services while also showing support for their families. In Arlington, Matthew Torres, WUSA 9.